Today, we are going to watch some video clips and to discuss with you why do they translate the titles of the films this way and if they are adequate, Russian equivalent to the English one. We know a lot of movies, but mostly you know them with the Russian title. And now we're going to discuss with you the English one. Probably I've chosen some most known for you, some known ones. And the first one is the Russian title "Karty, деньги, два слова". Do you know this movie?
Yeah.
Yeah. You
know. No. Do you know the Russian, the English title of it? Why is this movie called this way? Do you have any idea? Have you seen that movie?
Yes.
Yes.
What is this plot about? Well, if you have seen that movie, you know that, well, there is such a thing there as cards, money, and two guns.
Mm-hmm. And drugs.
So, in fact, but we haven't seen that in the title. So, in fact, the Russian title shows us that this is the movie about cards, money, and two guns. Well, let's see what is the English one.
Главный его талант были карты, точнее, азартная игра. Бейкон понимал, что толкать по закоулкам паленый товар долго не удастся. Надо было менять курс, и он это знал.
Карты, деньги, два ствола.
Lock, stock, and two smoking barrels. You know these words. What do they mean? What is lock? Замок. Stock. Two smoking barrels. Well, okay. If we look up in the dictionary, you will find this way. Лох. Замок, затвор. Сток. Ствол, оружейная ложа, запас, инвентарь. Barrel, бочка, ствол, дуло. What is common? Лох. Замок, затвор. Сток, оружейная ложа. Do you know what that means in Russian? Barrel, дуло. All about guns. And these are the three main parts of a gun. Lock, stock, and barrel. So now, can you imagine why do they call this way? Lock, stock, and two smoking barrels. No?
Because it sounds better.
If we say lock, stock, and barrel, we mean the whole gun, the whole thing. Well, if we go further and look up in the dictionary of idioms, we'll find that lock, stock, and barrel is an English idiom, which means полностью, целиком, все вместе взятое, решительно и бесповоротно. Even John Galsworthy in The White Monkey uses this phrase. So what does the English title show us, give us, what idea?
Something
complete. The whole thing, but it is changed. Lock, stock, and two smoking barrels. Two smoking barrels, we have another word, and we have it in plural. And now we know Russian translation of this version. So, what do you think? Is it equivalent? Is it adequate? The Russian translation to the English one.
The Russian equivalent show us the container of the film, no, and the English one, it is like an idiom.
But it is changed.
It is changed for...
Okay, we have, in English, we have lock, stock, and two smoking barrels. In Russian, we have карты, деньги, два ствола.
In Russian equivalent, we have three main things about this film.
Ну хорошо, они вот соответствуют друг другу. Нет, нормальный перевод.
Нет.
It sounds like gangsters.
Ты снимай все подряд, абсолютно, косит и хватит. Подряд все. What will you suggest? How would you translate the title? Any ideas?
Gun.
In Russian. So you have the title, Lock, Stock and Two Smoking Barrels. How will you translate in Russian? No ideas.
Замок, ложь и ствол.
Would you like to go and see that movie that is called in Russian? Замок, ложь и ствол.
Решительно.
Название фильма так и берем. Решительно и бесповоротно. Well, what I think? I think that this is quite adequate, the translation. This is a good one, I think. Карты, деньги, два стола. Because you cannot translate an English idiom. It is changed a little bit. If we have lock, stock and barrel, that's okay. So we translate. Решительно и бесповоротно. But it is changed. Two smoking barrels.
Well, plus it's a boring name, but they only know. Just lock, stock and barrel, if you translate it in Russian directly.
Here is another thing. The Russian title should be appealing to the people, like,
yeah,
people would like to see that. Oh, I see the title now, I want to see that movie. Mm-hmm. This is another thing which is very important here. Yeah. Well, let's see another movie. Все девять яблок. You know that movie, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But why is it called?
Все 9 ярдов.
What do we have here? We have the Russian equivalent to the English one. In English we have the whole 9 yards. In Russian we have все 9 ярдов. Is it okay?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it's like exact translation.
It's exact translation. And what does it mean to you? When you hear все 9 ярдов, what do you...
Something about sea, I don't know.
About money. We don't know exactly what to equivalent. I think it's not quite a good translation.
Let's see the video clip where they say this thing in the film. Do you remember that? No?
No.
It's about money, yes. And
how money with the whole 9 yards are connected?
The whole 9 yards is a big sum of money. It's
9 yards of money.
It's an idiom too.
It's an idiom, right, you are. But what does it mean, in fact? Let's see the clip where they say this.
Из-за денег. А, вы богаты? Лазло Гадалак нам дал деньги в качестве свадебного подарка. Это был не совсем подарок. Лазло нас так попросил подержать деньги на всякий случай. А сколько там было-то? 10 миллионов долларов.
Ничего себе, подержать. И чтобы получить деньги в банке, мы должны прийти вместе, Джимми, Яни и я. Нужны три подписи или две подписи плюс свидетельство о смерти. Или одна подпись и два свидетельства о смерти. Вот почему Джимми хочет убить вас, потому что если он убьет вас и Яни, тогда он получит деньги. Все. Да. Все 9 ярдов.
What did you just call me? You didn't want the money?
No.
Does it make sense?
Yeah. 9 million.
He will get all the money of the whole 9 yards. For me, it makes no sense at all.
Старше, как мы в русском говорим, там 10 кусков или там, не знаю, 10 лимонов.
For me, it makes no sense at all. This translation, like you will get all the money, the whole 9 yards. What possibly this phrase mean? The whole 9 yards?
Yeah, probably some amount of money.
The whole thing. Mm-hmm. Not exactly money, but anything. There are some ideas why they say so. Let's see these ideas. This is one idea. The cartridge belt of the machine gun is 9 yards length. So it means the hole. The whole cartridge. This is one idea, but I would like to say that these are just the ideas, it's not the correct answer. Seventh carrier. 9 yards. Fourth one, and the third one. Can you guess what will be written there? 9 yards of what? Length of?
What anchor?
Anchor chain. Or probably the sail. The length of the sail. You see, even here we have maybe these or maybe that. Your idea? Intestines. You know this word? Intestines. What does it mean? Nobody knows. In English, that is 9. Ну да, на седьмом небе у нас тоже есть фраза, да? And again, but this is online dictionary. Even here we have, you see, movie 9 yards. От начала до конца, all the way, if you want to run for mayor, I'll be with you the whole 9 years. So now we understand that if they say you'll get all the money the whole 9 years, this means that you will get the whole sum. So in fact, the translation is correct. In Russian there is no such phrase, such an idiom, like все девять ярдов. So it's better to say like всю сумму, да? And now, what about the title? The Russian title.
Я канадец, прямой похвой.
So we have in English the whole 9 yards, in Russian we have 9 yards. It looks like it is an adequate translation.
Oh, it's not, because this means the same translation. I mean, in Russian we can see that it's just a distance or something like that. But now how it is like the whole sum of something. I just think it's not very adequate.
Well, there is no exact point of view here. I think that's not an adequate translation. But on the other way, this translation, well, as we say, it's a kind of thing closer to America and to American idioms. So if the film about the United States, so we use the idiom about the United States, but not about Russia. Кстати, окрестком Орешкина, да? Do you know how this film, this movie is called in English? Die Hard. But these are the old movies. 2000, 1994. Let's see the new one. £7. £7. 7 жизней. Any ideas? Who has seen that movie?
It's like
pay
for rich life.
Yeah. £1 over what?
I know.
You know the answer.
It is the sum of his donation. He has donated his lungs, part of his liver, a material, a bone material, and his eyes. And in fact, all this is.
It costed
£7. It cost £7.
Well, if you have not seen that movie, first of all, let's see what is it about.
Комната номер 2.
Что произошло?
Здесь самоубийство.
Кто жертва?
Я.
Диплод. Was a gifted aerospace engineer with a wide language. If you are interested more in the plot, you can take a look, you can take a deeper look at the plot. If you haven't seen that movie, character responsible for the death of 7 other people, including his beloved wife. Unable to forgive himself or raise the dead, sets out to give pounds of flesh that will give new life to 7 deserving individuals. Different individuals, completely unknown for him. Tim intends to kill himself to atone for his sins. So, but why is it translated this way? £7. Now we see that a pound means in fact a pound of flesh. But it's not translated in Russian as 7 фунтов.
No, I think it's just translated correctly.
It just gives us the sense of the movie, not like something, you know, practical and like flash.
Do you know where the answer is? Why? Yes, pounds of flesh.
Okay.
It's not just the director or anybody else invented. This phrase existed long ago. And who was the creator of that? The idea of that, a pound of flesh. Imagine you are at the game who wants to be a millionaire or something like Jeopardy. And you have a question, just use your brains and you can guess. I like the game Jeopardy because you don't have to know all the words, all the answers, but you can guess just thinking. So a pound of flesh, where, what was the origin, possibly, of that phrase? Even if you don't know quite well the classical English or American literature. Okay. The answer is William Shakespeare, The Merchant of Venice. What was there?
The main character had to give a pound of his meat.
Flesh.
Flesh.
Or
for the money that he had to the merchant.
I don't know.
There are two main characters in that play. The one is the merchant, and another one is... Well, let's explain it this way. Another one is the person who gives money to the other people. And they have... And the other, these people have to give it back. With the interest rate, of course. Russian. Хочу вам другом быть, помочь вам и не взять с вас ни гроша процентов. Нотариусу вы со мной пойдите и напишите вексель в виде шутки. Когда вы не уплатите мне точно в такой-то день и там-то суммы долга указаны, назначу мне устойку. Фунт вашего прекраснейшего мяса. Чтобы выбрать мог часть тела я любую и мясо вырезать где пожелаю. Отлично, подпишу этот вексель. A pound of flesh and get it anywhere I like. So it means that probably he will take the life of that man, right? Because if you take a pound of flesh, maybe it's a heart. Some people say that the heart weighs a kind of about 1 pound. So this is the answer. Contest. Think over. We have Russian movie, Убийственные красотки. And we have the English title, Drop Dead Gorgeous. And another one is Свидетель, Eye of the Beholder. Any ideas?
Everything is in the eye of the beholder.
What means gorgeous?
Gorgeous? Божественно.
Шикарно.
Шикарно.
Классно.
Drop dead gorgeous. Ну, drop. Понятно. Dead? Тоже понятно. Gorgeous мы уже тоже знаем.
Все, потом я перевозил.
About beauty contest. We have Kirsten Dunst, Dennis Richards, Ellen Barkin, Kirstie Alley, So in fact this is an idiom again, and this is an idiom too.
Yes.
Drop that gorgeous means. Ну, умереть не встать, как мы говорим. Да? То есть настолько красиво, что вот просто вот убийственно красиво был один из вариантов перевода. Еще переводили. Вот на мой взгляд, самый более адекватный перевод это вооружена и смертельно красиво. Как-то вот так, по-моему, получалось. И смертельно опасно, что-то такое. Вот это один из вариантов. Ну а здесь фразу I think you know. The beauty is in the eye of the beholder. The part of the phrase again. What it means? What it means? You know? The beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Can you explain? It
means that a man на русском лучше объяснить. То есть человек, который там любит, он не видит недостатков такого.
Да. А я убили этого?
Сохраним интригу.
Просто если ее убили, то она сохранилась в глазах того, кто ее видел.
Нет. А это теория.
То есть если дословно переводить, то получается красота в глазах зрящего, да, дословно если переводить. Даже слово-то красивое какое, beholder, то есть это вот зрящий, смотрящий, да. Перевели просто свидетель. Но если не так, то как это перевести? So we have seen with you for not seen, but we discussed before movies. What can you say in general about the translation, about the meaning of the phrases? Can we make some kind of conclusion?
It's not so easy to translate the idioms into Russian language, so other people who do this translation should be careful and not and make understandable the meaning to people who want to learn.
This is one thing. Another thing.
And make it connected with the film, yes, with the plot.
What can you say about the titles of the films? So this is one thing. I mean English titles.
Basically,
how do they like to give titles?
They usually take idioms to
name
the film.
Well, I don't know. They don't give us the direct name of the film that tells us what's going to be going in the film. It gives us kind of like a trick name that we have to solve while watching it, probably.
Well, if you have some ideas for the future with your versions of translation with the equivalent and adequate translation of the English titles, maybe books, not possibly the films and the movies, maybe just right now something.
The film Another World, and when I watched the film, the title was Underworld.
Underworld. And the translation?
Другой мир.
Другой мир, but not like подземный мир, какой-нибудь там. Вот какой мир можно было бы назвать, да? Yes, you're right. Another thing that I'd like you to... So my aim was also to think over about the English title. So when you see the movie and you know the Russian title, so it's quite easy and... But when you know the English title and you know what it means in original, so it gives you new ideas to the film, to the plot, new understanding maybe. Am I right?
Yeah.
So, that maybe you haven't seen 7 pounds, but the whole 9 yards, you've seen, definitely, and you've seen crowds, dogs talking to small girls. And 7 pounds, if you watch that now, movie, so on TV, I think they will show it. So now you will get the idea of what in fact it means and why. Why the director chose that title for that movie, 7 pounds? He's fond of Shakespeare. Well, thank you. I think that's all for today.